Hey guys, this is Alekha from the BSRC Mars, and in this video we will be talking about various types of wheels that are popularly used in the First Tech Challenge. And we will also be explaining how to build a reliable and robust mechanum wheelbase for this year's FTC Rover Ruckus Challenge. So let's get started! Hey guys, this is Ronav, and now I will be explaining to you the different kinds of wheels which we can use in the FTC. So to my left hand side, we have these more simple wheels which we can use, and to my right, we have the more complex wheels available. So to start off, we have this Tetrix traction wheel. It has this kind of squishy rubber on the outside and a curved cross section which provides it a center pivot point, which is very important in turning. On the inside, it has alloy of nylon and plastic, which makes it pretty durable and sturdy. You can also see that the holes in the wheel are more kit specific to the Tetrix kit. So these wheels are available in various sizes. We have the 3-inch version of the wheel available here. Next up, we have the GoBuilder traction wheel. These wheels are also quite similar to the Tetrix wheels. The main difference between the wheels is the hole pattern in the GoBuilder wheel. It is more kit specific to the GoBuilder kit, but it is compatible with other kits too. So next up, we have Omni wheels. This is the 3-inch version available from the Tetrix kit. So Omni wheels can basically rotate in two axes, and thus they can cover movement in four directions, which is front and back and left and right. With the help of these tiny rollers here, which also provided traction. Tetrix Omni wheels have this hard nylon in the center, similar to the traction wheels, and have this Tetrix kit specific hole pattern in the center. We also have the larger ones from the GoBuilder kit. So this is also exactly the same to the Tetrix kit. The only difference is of the hole pattern in the center. So basically these Omni wheels can be stacked up together and be used in wheelbases, and thus they can cover movement in all directions. So these Omni wheels are pretty lightweight and just cost a little bit more than the traction wheels. So thus they are an important part of wheelbases. So next up, we have these mechanum wheels here. These ones are from Nexus Robotics and are currently available on Robot Shop. I'll put the link for these in the description below. So one of the most advanced and extremely useful drivetrains, which a lot of FTC teams use, is the Mechanum multi-directional drivetrain. So what this really is a bunch of wheels which have rollers positioned at an angle of 45 degrees, which allow the robot to not only move forward and backward, but also sideways. And what this really is a bunch of four wheels in which these two point inwards and these two point outwards. From our previous year's experience and after a lot of brainstorming, we have built this mechanum wheelbase, which was one of the best we could think of. In this video, we have used the GoBuilder kit for the demonstration, but of course, you can use the Tetrix and Acrobotics kits also. So now, I will be explaining the assembly of the basic wheelbase first, and then I will do the assembly of the mechanics. So as we all know, the key to building a successful robot is to have a strong and robust wheelbase. So keeping that in mind, we have used a combination of two 4-hole U-channels and one long 15-hole U-channel. The 4-hole U-channels are jointed by two screws at the front and at the back. So this sort of creates a sort of an inverted U-shape, which not only adds to the strength and the amount of weight that the bot can bear, but it also gives you enough ground clearance so that when you plan to take the robot in the crater in the autonomous period or during the end of the game. So we have basically built a symmetrical design for the other side too, which is over here. And these two symmetrical designs were jointed by two separate GoBuilder low-heighted U-channels, one in the center and one at the back. So now moving on to the wheels. We first have to put together various parts to make a setup for the mechanum wheel.
You can see we have used two D-hubs here, one at the front and one at the back. I'll put the link in the description for all the wheels below. So once you've inserted the axle through four of the wheels and through the go-builder channel, you just have to connect two bearings and then we are done. Well, this is not the only way you can construct piano wheel bases. You can also use other kits like Tetris and Actobotics. But we have created this design after a lot of research on mechanics and drive brakes. And the end result is an extremely reliable, robust and fast drive brake. So that's it for today. I hope you found all of this information useful. And if you would like to see more content from our channel, please like, subscribe and press the bell icon. And let me know in the comments below.